according to my earnest expectation and my hope, that in nothing I shall be ashamed, but that with all boldness, as always, so now also Christ shall be magnified in my body, whether it be by life or by death. I chose the scripture because it's a very powerful scripture for me today, knowing that being called by the Lord to love Him and to love my brothers, that my speech, my actions, my behaviors should all reflect that love, and that I shall not be ashamed. I shall be purified, sanctified, and forgiven my sins to the Lord Jesus Christ. That is my strength, that is my hope, and my expectation. That's a good scripture. Philippians 1:20.
If there is any consolation in Christ, if any comfort in love, if any fellowship of the Spirit, if any affection and mercy, fulfill my joy by being like-minded, having the same love, being of one accord and one mind. Let nothing be done through selfish ambition or conceit, but in lowliness of mind, let each esteem other better than himself. I chose this portion of scripture because I think this scripture is vital to living in a house with six guys. We understand that being selfless is a command of the Lord, and it's done in being one with the Spirit as well, and I believe that's how we please God, with being like-minded, and it takes a lot of humility and selflessness to pull this off, and of course the Holy Spirit working in and through each one of us. That's what I have to say. I love this verse, and it's really example. Yeah. Amen.
And that you make the most of every opportunity that you have. that you live for that day, because that's the only day the Lord has to be faithful to that which is weak. And as He's prepared you, and as He's building Christ in you, and your character is developing, it's a process that He's in control. Just remember, there's no plan B with God.
I am a peacemaker. My job, my calling, is to serve the Lord. I serve it by being His secretary and being the famous poet that I am. One scripture that God has in my head, has in my heart, is Psalm 49. Be quiet, be still, and know. I do this all the time on a daily basis. I serve the Lord on a daily basis. And the point is to get it done. And for them to believe and keep your faith through the economic insecurity.
This is Romans 5:8. Romans 5:8 says, "But God demonstrates His own love for us in this, while we were still sinners, Christ died for us." And that scripture relates to me is that I now know that no matter how perfect I'm not, and no matter how righteous I'm going to try to become in God, God is God, and He still loves us even though we mess up sometimes and we have problems, and knows that He's like our Father. He cares about us, and He's always with us to help us grow in strength and knowledge and wisdom and in power, and to overcome anything and every mountain that we have, and be able to move and push anything that we can need and move to push. And God is awesome.
With all holiness and humility, with patience, bearing with one another in love.
Exodus chapter 3, verse 14, God said to Moses, "I am who I am." And He said, "Thus you shall say to the sons of Israel, I am has sent me to you." This verse is powerful because I'm a living testimony of that. The Lord used certain people to come and minister unto me, but He has sent them to me. And now that I've known in the Lord, I understand that the Lord is who He said He is. If you're down and out, you'll become your comforter. If you're hungry, you'll become the bread for you to eat. And if you're thirsty, you'll become the water for you to drink. And since He says I am who I am, now I also know that He is worthy of His praise. Amen.
All the time?
God's good.
Amen.
All right.